Fitch Ratings is keeping its positive outlook for the Philippines' credit rating, despite tighter monetary policies in the U.S. The country's strong foreign exchange reserves make it more resilient than most of its Asian peers. The debt watcher remains cautious, though, for the rest of emerging markets in Asia, saying uncertainty remains on how quick U.S. interest rates will rise and if it will be in line with the market expectations. Earlier, I spoke with Fitch Ratings head of Asia-Pacific Sovereigns, Andrew Colquhoun, and he says the Philippines is relatively insulated from these global risks, which include the latest Fed liftoff, and that another upgrade in the country's credit rating is highly possible.
Well, yesterday's rise was well signaled and in line with Fitch's expectation. I think the real uncertainty remains how quickly rates rise and to what peak. So there's still a significant gap between where the Fed is telling us it sees rates going and what the market is pricing in. So if the outturn is closer to what the Fed is saying, i.e. rates rise more quickly than the market's currently expecting, that would be a potentially a substantial shock, particularly for Asia Pacific, where private sector debt levels have risen rapidly and where capital flows have already started to reverse, although Philippines is one of the least exposed in the region, consistent with a positive outlook on its rating.
It is one of the least exposed, but in the many years we've seen a lot of capital inflows, it's become outflows in the past couple of months, making this the biggest in foreign selling for the year. To what extent is this a risk for the credit ratings for the Philippines?
I don't think it's much of a risk for the Philippines compared to other sovereigns. Philippines has a structural current account surplus, and its external finances have progressively strengthened in recent years, and the country's become a net external creditor. That strengthening in the external finances is an important buffer against any volatility induced by the Fed's liftoff.
What do you think the central bank has to do as the monetary policies in emerging economies diverge with that of the U.S.?
Again, I think for Philippines, probably Fed liftoff is more constructive than it is for many other countries in the region. I mean, there are those countries that, you know, where growth is weakening or that suffer from high levels of private sector debt, where importing tighter monetary policy from the U.S. is kind of the last thing they need. In Philippines, I think it's a bit of a different situation. There's very abundant domestic liquidity. The central bank's problem has more been how to mop up and how to control that liquidity. So tighter kind of dollar rates globally is probably something that's more constructive than Philippines than it is for many of the other countries.
And finally, what are the chances of an upgrade in the next 12 to 18 months?
Well, our positive outlook signals that we see a better than 50% likelihood of an upgrade in that time frame, the next 12 to 18 months. We assigned the outlook in November of this year. I think if we and the key drivers that we identified were the progressive improvement in the sovereign balance sheet, so the reduction in government debt ratios and the foreign reserves buffer, and also the improvements in governance and institutional quality that have taken place under the Aquino presidency. Now, if those governance improvements and broad policy continuity looks set to continue under the next president, whoever that is, then that would be supportive of an upgrade.